NHL super agent Taylor Mackey joins us here on the line, who represents the hottest, most anticipated prospect in years. Taylor, give us the 411 on the kid here.
Hey, morning, James. Well, look, you may not believe this, but the kid's up here on Carter Lake.
What?
Playing pickup, yeah, with a bunch of other kids. Just, it's a beautiful day.
Pricey pond hockey you got going there.
Yeah, I suppose it is. But look, that's how much this kid loves the game, man.
Well, just safety first up there. Now,
of course,
I got to ask you, we've seen the scouting reports, we've seen the highlights, but we know about the player. But tell me more about the person. What's this rookie really like?
Yeah, sure, James. Let's begin by telling your listeners at home the kid's name.
Better to talk about the upcoming Memorial Cup than a guy who's actually hoisted the trophy, Ray Ferraro. Does that conjure up some memories there for you?
Yeah, you bet it does. What an awesome time in your career. It's the most important games that you've played in your life, really, until that time.
We are getting closer to puck drop for this Memorial Cup and Game 1 here. We bring Ray Ferraro back into the fold, and boy, the scout cam should be on full display tonight, won't they? He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski, ready to call the action. As we send it down ringside to Ray Ferraro, you look at these two teams and the way they operate from special teams, this could be a key area tonight.
Yeah, both teams were talking this morning about the need to stay out of the penalty box. Don't give the opportunity for the other team's power play to get rolling.
Two teams hungry for 2 points, and we are ready to drop the puck. Lots of time left in this period. The game is still scoreless. Kelonen's got a hold of the puck off the draw. Not able to connect. St- steps inside. Puck knocked loose in the neutral zone. Connor's taken down to the ice. We got a penalty coming up. Here comes the official's decision. The Firebirds will serve 2 minutes in the box. Played with fire, he got burned, Ray.
He's digging around for the puck, and sometimes you just get caught. This time the player goes down, and he's got to go to the box.
The Rockets get their man advantage unit out there for the first time tonight.
Hey, here's a power play, and the game is scoreless. What a nice opportunity for them to kick the other team in the shins a little bit, get the lead, and play from in front.
Standing by, our own Carlin Bave with all the latest.
Thanks so much, James. You know, the rookie is playing in his very first Memorial Cup, and the hype around social media is real. They're calling him a game changer for whatever team gets him.
Yeah, a lot of buzz about him as play continues here.
I wanted another look at this one. I'm sure you guys were all impressed as I was. What a save by the goalie.
The Firebirds take possession off the faceoff. Gets it out of his own end. Takes the feed in the middle of the neutral zone. Both teams back to even strength as the power play comes up empty-handed, and we are still tied. His reflexes on display tonight.
Well, when the puck moves and the feet don't, this is what you get. You have lots of zone time, but no real dangerous chances on that power play. Those are the saves that are gifts from the goaltender. That looked like an automatic goal. He's able to make the stop.
Plenty of playing time left in this frame. Still no score in this one. And with the two centers tangled up, the winger skates away with it. Takes the feed at center and moves forward. Pins them against the boards as they battle for the loose puck. The Firebirds gain possession along the wall. Throws one up to Kidd. Down the right side and into the zone. Sends the pass over. Moves the puck. And he comes up with it. Moves it quickly over to Kidd. Here's an odd man rush. The Rockets gain possession in their own end. Kelonen's got it across the line. Gets control of the puck here in his own end. Working to shake the pressure from the defensive zone. And it's grabbed by a teammate. From the right wing, he moves it to the middle. Time to execute here on this power play. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Pokes it away in his own end. Loose puck battle along the boards. The Rockets take it along the wall. The Firebirds have it against the wall. Both sides are evened up as the power play has expired. The Rockets get a hold of the puck in their own end. Through center. Jostling for the puck and he loses control. Receives the pass. Shot from the wall. Off a stick. Comrie's lugging the puck. Streaking through center, they go on the attack. And he takes a shot, stopped by the goaltender. Here in the late goings of the period, still looking for our first goal. Kids won the faceoff. Flint's looking to break out. Scoops up the puck here. Kelonen's got a hold of it along the wall. Jabs the puck away. Pinned up along the boards. Up along the wall on the right side and into the attacking area. Flint's gonna play it from the corner. Takes a shot. Oh, what a good opportunity right there.
You don't get many chances. You want to finish them off, so he'll be a little frustrated as he heads back up ice.
Takes a shot. Nice save by the keeper to trap that puck in his chest. The centers will glide into the dot. Kelonen's won the draw. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. Kelonen's got a hold of the puck. Move to the middle. A chance, and he makes the save. That concludes the first period. Really, both teams still filling each other out here as we are still scoreless. And while both teams get a refresher, we'll take one ourselves heading into the second period. Both teams had a chance to recharge, and the officials set to drop the puck here on period number two. The Rockets move it in. Here's a blast off target. Grabs the puck and looks to make something happen. Battle along the boards. Takes the feed at the back end. And a poke check knocks the puck away. They've got numbers. Moves it to Kidd. Scores! The future is now.
James, this kid scores. He dials up the celly, and everybody around him is excited. He has got all kinds of potential in front of him. Geez, I like this, James. When the puck's in their hands, they attack, and they attack in layers. The odd man rush is worked to perfection.
The Firebirds are up by one here in the second.
I've liked a lot of their game, but it's like they can't get these other guys to go away. It stays close, but at least they're playing from in front.
Takes it across the blue line. Good defensive stop with the poke check. Moves it around along the half wall. Here he is in front! Big save! Great reflexes, another save! Flint's got the puck along the wall. Nice poke check. The Rockets move it ahead. Into the offensive zone. Excellent stick work on the play. That pass goes a little sideways. Puck battle along the boards. Good heads up play in the defensive zone. Taken by Poole. Kolonis got it along the wall. And as he stumbles, he coughs up the puck. Manages to hang on. Takes the feed. Puts it on net. Oh, and he completely blew it on that miss.
Yeah, you got to get it on the net, James. You've got an opportunity to score, and you don't even test the goalie.
Too much congestion blocks the shot. The Rockets will play it from the defensive zone. Kolonis in now. Big play inside the defensive zone. Here he is in front! Swing and a miss! And that one's broken up by a great defensive play! Inching closer to the midway mark of this period, Flint's ahead 1-0. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. Kolonis got possession here in their own end. A chance to get it out of the defensive zone. Whoa, close call on the bench as the puck sails out of play. The Rockets win the draw. Puck clears the zone. Flint's gained possession along the boards. Here's a short pass to Kidd. Oh, smart heads up play to poke that one away. Sails over the net.
You kick yourself in the tail after you miss a chance like this. Has to be on the net.
The Firebirds will go to work here in the offensive zone. That opportunity is rejected. More than half the frame has been played here. 1-0 is where we sit at this point. The frozen biscuits dropped and we are back underway here. And the puck is moved to a safer spot on the ice. Flint's got a hold of it against the wall. With some open space at center. On the doorstep! Oh, what a stop! Here's a chance to get it out of their own end. And it's a small victory for the PK unit here. Well, that's their job. Get it down the ice, get off the ice, get some new people out there.
Couldn't make that one happen. And he regains control of the puck. Here's a shot. He scores! Put the special in special teams.
Well, the coaches have been talking about a few new wrinkles on the power play. They moved the puck nicely, and the puck is in the back of the net on the power play. Well, the only way he's stopping this one is if it hits him. As soon as the shooter went to shoot it, the goaltender dropped into the butterfly. He's looking around that traffic, hoping he can find it.
Flint's now extended the lead to two here in this second.
I really like the way that they've gotten after it, James. Even up just one, they didn't take a backward step. Kept pumping pucks to the net, and now they get a second.
Takes the pass. Move to the middle, and that one's broken up. Couldn't find the intended target, and they fail to go tape to tape. Pumps the puck away. The Firebird scooping up along the boards. Trying to get back on the attack now. Colonna's trying to make something happen in the offensive zone, and he denied that opportunity. Firebirds continue to lead in the second. They have been the busier team in the shot department, and as a result, they lead. Kids want it in their own end. Scoops up the puck now. Takes the feed. The Firebirds looking against the half wall. A chance! Glove save, and he handles it with ease.
We often talk about a goalie's reflexes. You've got to have quick hands to make a glove stop like that.
Sends a pass over. Puck scooped up by Kidd. Too many bodies in the way. Handles the puck. Can't maintain possession. Quick pass to Kidd. Right in front! And that skips away on a nice defensive deflection. Moves the puck into the attacking area. The Firebirds gain possession along the wall. From the left side, he moves it up ahead. They've got numbers. It's a two-on-one. Denies him in front.
And he came out and challenged him. Good save.
Strong defensive effort. Comrie's got the puck in his own zone. Here's a chance. To his teammate. Scores! Quick blast. No chance.
His work rate off the puck here is what got him the spot to shoot from. He found the spot, was able to set up, and then takes no time to put it away.
Kelowna's got a chance to change the complexion of this game now with that one.
Yeah, get one, now they're within one. Don't take a step back. Push forward. Look for the equalizer.
And the sound of the horn will wrap things up for period number two in what has been a tightly contested affair. Don't go anywhere. Third period is just around the corner. They're ready to drop the puck on period number three. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Let's do this. Here we go. Put up or shut up for both teams here in this third period. We are underway. Once again, I'll send it back down to my broadcast partner, Ray Ferraro, who is at ringside. Ray, we've got two periods played. How do you see this thing?
The Rockets are behind in this game, James, after two periods. And really, for me, it's no surprise. They've turned the puck over constantly tonight.
Good defensive effort to poke it away.
Quick feed to Kidd. Nice save off the tender's pad. Colonna's got the puck in the defensive end. Nice pass. Colonna's got the puck along the boards. Smart defensive play here in the open ice. Takes a shot and makes a save. Denies him again. Gains the zone through the middle. The Firebirds take possession here in the open ice. Moves it quickly over to Kidd. Here's a shot, and that one's turned away.
You know when you're looking for...
Scores!
You get one, you get hungry for a second one. Even if you're not a goal scorer, you get that early. Now you want to hunt for a second goal.
Makes it a double on the play.
As a great older colleague of mine says, this is waffle-boarded away. You got to get into the middle of the ice to score. He's in the low slot. He whips the backhander past the goalie. In a close game, James, the coach is showing a lot of confidence in his rookie. The youngster will go back on the ice here with the instruction of carry the play, push the pace. They don't want to sit back.
Interesting play as they try to preserve this lead here. This one, but they're up by two. How does that change things?
Well, it gives you more cushion, of course. You can do math.
Sometimes.
Yeah, but they don't really have to change too much here. I think they just continue to play in the style they are.
Colonna's got the puck against the half wall. Pokes it away in his own end. The Rockets move the puck in the defensive zone. Lee's got it behind the cage. Gains the zone. Sends it across. Way too much congestion blocks that. Up along the wing. From center they get into the attacking area. Moves it to Roberts. And that pass goes awry. Colonna's got it in their own zone. Here they are on the attack. And he slides it quickly to Kidd. Here's a chance! Blocker save, and he's showing up big time tonight! Here's a short pass to Kidd. A spirited battle along the boards for the puck. The Rockets have it against the wall. Here they come. The Rockets carry it along the wall. Great defensive effort with the stick. And he's tripped up on the play. Referee's hand goes up here. Time for the official to pass down his sentence. Looks like tripping the call.
Sometimes they're lazy, sometimes they're just bad luck.
The Firebirds send their man advantage unit out once more.
Well, they've earned another power play, James. Of course, that starts with an offensive zone faceoff.
Picking up some steam at center ice. Drives to the crease. Gives them nothing in front. Again, the denial by the goaltender.
Well, what a quick reflex stop that is. Great scoring chance.
Flint's been the better team tonight. They have turned good defense into solid offense, and they lead here in the third. Kidd's won the draw. Takes a shot. Oh, denies him with the save. I think he got the blocker on it. Colonna's across the blue line. Hangs onto the puck. Colonna's PK unit comes up big as both sides are back to even strength.
Well, it's still looking bleak and up here. They've got to climb back into the game, but if their PK doesn't do the job there, they wouldn't have had any chance.
Made the save on the play. And he can't hang on after that hit.
Kidd's eyes are looking for three. He's got two in his back pocket. Dangerous player now.
The Rockets are in transition. From one point man to another. Stones him in front. Here in the back half of this period, the Firebirds have been getting solid offensive contributions, leading 3-1. Gets a hold of the puck here in his own end. Colonna's got a hold of it along the wall. The Rockets have it in the offensive zone. Kolonis on the attack. Here he is, wrists it on net. Oh, he might be shaking his head after that one.
Pretty good shot, nice delivery of the shot, but the goaltender beats him.
The Rockets take possession in the defensive end. Great hit on the play. Quick pass to Kidd with the stop. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. They've got the defense outnumbered. Here's a chance with the stop. Another stop by the goaltender. Kolonis looking to break out of their own end. The Rockets take it across the line. On the attack along the boards. Stopped by the goaltender.
Oh, he had to get up tight to the puck. In close, he takes away any room. He had to be on top of his game to make that stop. That's a great scoring chance, and he turns it aside.
Late goings of this period, Flint's got a 3-1 lead. The Firebirds get a hold of the puck in their own end. And now it's grabbed by Kidd. And he gains the zone here. Wrists one. He scores! That's the hat trick!
Little tweak to the crowd here on the road as he gets it third. An outstanding game so far. Excellent puck movement on the odd man rush. They catch them short and they make them pay. The rookie's had a really good game and he gets a little tap from the coach as he comes back to the bench. That doesn't happen very often. Pretty satisfying when you know the boss is happy with you.
We've called his name multiple times. He's been all over the ice tonight. The Firebirds could almost put this one in neutral here for the rest of this third period.
They've dominated much of this game and the score is clearly reflective of that.
Kids won the draw here in the neutral zone. Takes the feed at center and moves up ahead. Pokes it away here in the neutral zone. Less than 60 seconds to play in this blowout. Gets in front of it. Grabs it in his own end. Scrum along the boards. Flint's got it in their own zone. Slides the puck over. Quick feed to Kidd. Centered out in front. Scores!
Three straight goals here. They have really laid the boots to those guys in the last little bit. That's a scorer's goal right there. That puck is on and off his stick in a hurry. He's so tight to the net. He has to get rid of it before the goalie can readjust.
Flint's only continued to extend the lead here in the third.
They haven't missed many chances. They've scored at will and now are coasting home.
Puck is dropped and we are back underway. And now it's over to Kidd. Along the half wall with the puck. Takes the feed at the point. Blocked in traffic. Into the offensive end now. Moves it quickly over to Wong. And the traffic jam in front blocks the shot. Move to the middle. He scores.
It's a second goal for the James, and I guess they can look at after the game and say, oh, we got a couple. But, man, this has just been not a very good night for them. The goalie's not going to catch up to that, is he? That slapper went right past him.
Flint's up big time here in the late stages of this third period. Nice job tying up his opponent. Final buzzer sounds, and this one's in the books.
Well, they get the win and really controlled many of the small areas of the game. They were good in the faceoff. Their center ice position is such a strength for them.
He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. We will see you in the next round of this tournament as it continues on. Good night. Absolutely phenomenal performance. And here to talk a little more about what we saw on the ice is Ray Ferraro. And Razor, I mean, what does that do for his draft stock?
Oh, man, it'll put a rocket to it if he continues to play in this tournament like that. The scouts are going to get more and more interested. Also, a little more jittery, as they might have had a player slotted in a certain area of the draft. He plays like that, he's going to jump a couple of spots in the draft for sure. This is really an important start to the tournament for him.
Yeah, and this is where kind of all of a sudden the stocks kind of rise and fall here, right? We'll be right back.